Welcome, students and faculty.
This is your source for news from campus to the world.
Coming from our studio in Alumni Hall for the Maine Channel.
This is a Today, Tonight, and Tomorrow show.
These are major powers.
I'm having trouble trying to sleep. I'm counting sheep, not running out. As for cross tops in my mind, on my own, here we go.
Hello, I'm Ben Sullivan.
And I'm Caitlin O'Connor. The official results of the student government are in today, and you may be surprised as to what is going on.
Also, tickets go on sale tonight for the Quebec trip. We'll let you know how to pick those tickets up.
Plus, MySpace is cracking down on sex offenders.
And we'll talk with Heather Steeves about the weather and Amanda Chassie about sports. First, we'll take a look at what's happening in D.C. on Wednesday in Washington. A high-level commission said the President Bush's policy is not working. The bleak assessment urged administration to embrace diplomacy and to stabilize the country to allow withdrawal of most combat troops by early 2008. The report said Bush should put aside misgivings and engage Syria, Iran, and the leaders of insurgent forces in negotiations on Iraq's future, and urged him to revive efforts at a broader Middle East peace. Barring a significant change, it warned of a, quote, slide towards chaos.
And student government elections were held earlier this week, and the results are finally in. Paran Chandrasekhar took the majority of the presidential votes with over 900. Behind him was Derek Mitchell with almost 550 votes. Kevin Bellew finished third with over 200 votes. The vote for vice president was a much closer one, with Bill Pomerleau beating Sean Rankin with 55% of the vote. The referendum passed easily, with 81% of the student body voting pass it. While Paran Chandrasekhar might be the unofficial winner of the student body presidential election, there is still controversy surrounding the procedure, as two students brought forth complaints to the Fair Elections Practice Commission this past Wednesday. Eben Strout and Amanda Mullen brought forth complaints citing a first-class advertisement the day of elections, as well as flyers being hung near the computer cluster in the union. Both were violations of the FEPC guidelines, thus Chandrasekhar was found guilty before the panel. Their guilty verdict entails a vote to take place on first class on Tuesday, December 12th, asking the students whether this is enough to keep Chandrasekhar from being student body president. If students decide that this is enough to remove Chandrasekhar as president, then there will be elections between the two remaining candidates, Kevin Bellew and Derek Mitchell. As always, the Today, Tonight, and Tomorrow show will keep you informed on all future proceedings. Now let's see what those around campus feel about this subject.
I think that if he was posting campaign material the day of the election, and that's against the rules, but it's after the election, like it is, that this problem is being raised, that it should be put to the students, and the students should be allowed to decide if there should be another vote or if he should be disqualified.
I didn't know that was a rule, so I think it's kind of stupid. I think they should make it more clear, or at least let, like, the students know, like, you know, candidates can't do this on a certain day.
You know, if it was something on purpose, then yeah, that would be a different scenario that would be uncalled for. All of his votes shouldn't count. But if it was an honest mistake, then they should put it to a revote.
I think it's sort of stupid because, first of all, it's what's best for the campus and the students. So why would you disqualify someone just for something as minor as campaigning on the day of the election when they ultimately could be something that's going to really benefit us as a student population? So I don't think he should be disqualified.
Hi.
This just in, Derek Mitchell, a candidate for student body president and current senator, officially withdrew from the executive election and student government effective December 15th. In an email addressed to the senators of student government, Mitchell states that the VPSE is a great position, but one that he no longer wishes to fill. I wish the best of the candidates for the position. There has been some controversy over whether or not President-elect Priyanth Chandrasekhar campaigned fairly leading up to the election earlier this week. In a statement given today, to the Today, Tonight, and Tomorrow show, Mitchell feels that students voiced their decision in a vote on Monday. I question if any improper campaigning really persuaded too greatly the outcome of the election. Coming up next, find out about a spicy gift that will help out coming up on a group here on campus. Don't go away.
Randy Perkins, Director of Promotions here at the Maine Channel. I'm offering you a chance to get more recognition for your organization and more participation. Here at the Maine Channel, we are working on several different programs that are made for students and by students. Take, for example, Mouthguard, UMaine's premier boxing debate show. For those sports fans out there, we have Black Bear Nation, a weekly sports program that keeps students up to date with Black Bear sports teams. And what would any channel be without the news? The Today, Tonight, and Tomorrow show airs live twice a week that focuses on campus news. Like I said earlier, we want to promote your organization, no matter what it is. Maine Channel Promotions will provide your commercials free of charge and will place them wherever these great shows are aired. So contact myself, Randy Perkins, on First Class, or come on down to the station at 219 Alumni Hall and check us out. And remember, all promotions with us are free, so don't pass this up.
Mom?
Dad?
How long should I wait for you? Mom?
If I'm at soccer practice.
What if something happens? Will you come get me?
There's no reason not to have a plan in case of a terrorist attack.
Mom, if you're not home, should we go to the neighbor's house?
And some extremely good reasons why you should.
Can you tell me?
Talk to your family about what you would do in case of an emergency. For more information, go to www.ready.gov.
Score and 7 years ago.
Think history is a little scary? Then log on to loc.gov and see how much fun it can be. The Library of Congress at loc.gov.
I heard about this company dumping toxins in local rivers, and I called their executives to say stop. But they were too busy counting profits while the rivers are being destroyed, birds and fish are dying, and the local kids are getting cancer. So I organized a huge protest, and they actually got the company shut down. But now half the town's unemployed, and the kids are twice as sick since they can't get health care, since their parents lost the insurance they had when they worked for the company who dumped all the toxins in the first place.
Taste of winter the other day, having 2 days full of snow. Later, we'll check in and see if that's going to continue. We have had a very warm day today, reaching up into the 50s at some points. We'll see if this will continue later. Stay with us.
If you're still looking for that perfect Christmas gift, a group of chemical engineers have come up with a gift idea that might help you while it definitely helps them. A group from campus is competing in the National American Institute for Chemical Engineers annual Chemicare competition, and they are selling spice racks to fundraise. The spice rack includes 40 tubes and corks and a stainless steel rack. The gift will cost $30 and will help send the Chemicare team to the Nationals. The team placed first and second in the Northeast Regional competition. For more information, contact Robert Fisher on First Class.
Tickets for the annual Quebec trip will officially go on sale tonight in the Union. The ROC-sponsored trip will cost $65 on campus for students and $85 for non-residents. The fee will cover the bus ride and two nights in a hotel in the heart of Quebec during the 52nd annual Winter Carnival. The trip is scheduling to leave Friday, February 2nd, next year. Tickets will go on sale at 9:30 in the basement level of the Union. Due to the popularity of the trip, the ROC suggests that students get in the line early. Only cash and checks are accepted, and students can only purchase tickets for themselves.
One of UMaine's professors has been recognized as one of 24 distinguished scientists in an international selection process managed by the Association of Computing Machinery. Professor Dr. Michael Warbois from the UMaine Department of Spatial Information Science and Engineering has been recognized in the first annual nomination and selection process for his contributions to spatial science. The core criterion for all recipients is that they must have made significant accomplishments or achieved a significant impact on the computing field, as attested to in letters of nomination and support by well-respected peers in their disciplinary domain. This recent work of Warbois was his event-oriented models of dynamic spatial information systems. In addition to the 24 distinguished scientists, 17 distinguished engineers, and 8 distinguished members of an ACM were also recognized. Corporations that had a leading scientists and engineers recognized include Google, Intel, IBM, Microsoft Systems, Yahoo, and Sun Microsystems.
UMaine Provost Edna Moore Zeminski has rescheduled the first of a series of campus conversation. The meeting has rescheduled from November 28th to December 12th from 3:30 to 5. The topic of conversation will be improving retention and graduation rates for UMaine students and will be held in the Topman Room of the Memorial Union. For any more information, contact Wanda Legier on first class or at 581-1516.
Tomorrow evening, the Maine Steiners will be performing at Hawk Auditorium. The performance will begin at 7, and special guest Soul Expression will also be performing. The Maine Steiners are an all-male a cappella group on campus and are known for their tight harmonies, diverse repertoire of original arrangements, and energetic stage performance. Tickets cost $5 and will be on sale at the door. Next on 3T, we'll be talking with Amanda Chassie about your UMaine sports and find out what you can do to help support women's hockey team. This is today, tonight, and tomorrow's show.
I heard about this company dumping toxins in local rivers, and I called their executives to say stop. But they were too busy counting profits while the rivers are being destroyed, birds and fish are dying, and the local kids are getting cancer. So I organized a huge protest, and we actually got the company shut down. But now half the town's unemployed, and the kids are twice as sick since they can't get health care since their parents.
Passing gas in the presence of others is not only inappropriate.
That is so foul.
It can be deadly. Passing gas releases a fog of carbon monoxide.
Grandpa!
And other poisonous fumes that can contribute to asthma and pneumonia.
You're killing us over here.
Kids shouldn't be exposed to secondhand smoke. Don't pass gas. Take it outside.
Recently.
Yeah, finally, it seems like they're coming back after they hit a bump in the road at the beginning of the season there.
Yeah, but they're coming back. Well, the UMaine hockey team didn't really have a November to remember, but started off this month undefeated. UMaine beat New Brunswick in OT last night in the exhibition game here at Alphon Arena. Tony Marone scored the game winner for the Bears at 2:29 into the extra session. Teddy Purcell and Brett Tyler both scored while Tyler's goal was on Maine's second power play in the first period. Maine is ranked third in the nation according to the USCHO.com poll with a 9-3-1 record, following Minnesota and New Hampshire. But in Hockey East play, they're in fifth place with a 4-3-1 record, and they will travel to Beantown on Saturday to play Northeastern for yet another one-game weekend. The Huskies are 2-7-2 in Hockey East play, and this will be the last Hockey East game before semester break.
University of Maine senior guard John Sheets was named the America East Player of the Week on Monday. Sheets led the Maine's basketball team to 2 road victories, averaging 19 points per game. Sheets is the second on the team in scoring, assists, and steals, and leads Maine with 22 three-point field goals on the season. The boys hit the road and returned to action when they traveled to Providence to face the Friars this Saturday at 7:30 p.m. The women's basketball team is looking for their 5th straight victory when the girls travel to Worcester, Mass. to battle Holy Cross at 7 p.m. tonight. The girls are 5-1 and are on top of the America East standings. The ladies are in the middle of a 6-game road trip and will be on the road for the entire month of December. They will return to January 4th when they host the New Hampshire Wildcats. Meanwhile, in the NBA, the Celtics had a tough loss last night against the Grizzlies even after the impressive 14-0 run in the fourth to rally and tie it up. But rookie Rudy Gay of Memphis hit a jumper with 2 seconds left in the game to give them the lead over Boston and make a 98-96 defeat. Paul Pierce had 26 points and Gerald Green chipped in 21, but wasn't enough to beat Memphis at the Garden. Celtics mosey on down to first last place again in their division and are 2 games back behind the New Jersey Nets. They play the Phoenix Suns at home on Friday at 7 p.m. The Patriots travel to Miami this Sunday to face the Dolphins. New England will face a tough test on the road against a team that has won 4 out of the last 5 games. If they win, they will clinch the AFC East championship, but only if the Jets lose the Bills. If this happens, the Pats will have a 3-game lead on the Jets with only 3 games remaining. They will also be on track for a first-round playoff bye. And if the Pats leave Miami with a W, this will be the first back-to-back wins in Miami in 18 years. They will have to pull out with a win without veteran Ronnie Harrison and free safety Eugene Wilson due to a shoulder and a groin injury during this must-win matchup. And that is all for sports this week.
Good.
It's good.
Patriots look good.
Yeah.
Celtics, not so good.
Hey, beginning of the season.
Oh, all right. Well, winter is quickly approaching, and as your homework piles up and the weather becomes cold, it's still possible to take a break from everything and show your school spirit. Tomorrow night in the Alfond Arena, the Maine women's hockey team is playing in Lawrence. And for those who wish to participate in cheering the team, you should meet in the north pod of the Memorial Union at 6 p.m., dressed in blue and white, and bring your face paint. 5 spots are open for the Naked 5 to cheer on the Black Bears. Posters will be made in the Union, and everyone will head to the game together afterwards. Don't forget your Maine card to get into the game. See you on Friday night to support the team.
Weaving in a poor performance on sobriety tests earned University of Maine assistant women's basketball coach Kathy Carlson a seat on the bench last month. Carlson is now pleading not guilty to an arrest that occurred on November 5th. Carlson was taken into custody after blowing a .15 into a breathalyzer, which revealed that her blood alcohol level was twice above the legal limit. Carlson was released from custody after being issued a summons for a criminal OUI. Head coach Ann McNerney was also present in the vehicle. After attempting to give the officer a false name when asked for identification, McNerney walked home from the scene. Since the event, McNerney has issued a public apology for her role in the incident and has not faced any other administrative penalties. After her arraignment on November 28th, Carlson was told to change her plea or seek a trial. Carlson's position as assistant coach was suspended for 3 games and now is back in action with the Lady Bears in their 5-1 season record.
When we come back, we'll be talking with Heather Steves and we'll check out the weekend weather forecast.
Girl online is easy. They're so desperate for attention.
Attention from older guys is flattering. They get me more than guys my age.
Age lets me play the supportive older guy and act interested.
Interested in the same things. You get to know someone when you're
chatting. Chatting seems unthreatening to them. Once I talk about how perfect we are for each other.
Other people don't understand. If you trust someone, what's wrong with me?
Meeting them is the goal. That's when things get really interesting.
Online predators know what they're doing. Do you?
Being there makes all the difference.
Emeril Lagasse, Wolfgang Puck, Julia Childs. Does your name deserve to be on this list? Well, if it does, then the recipe competition is the place for you to show your stuff. The Nutrition Club is holding a competition for the best recipe on campus, and everyone on campus is invited to participate. Prizes will be given to the four winners of each category. The four categories are a quick and easy meal, a meal prepared in less than 30 minutes, good for you, a meal containing fruit or vegetables, and a whole grain, sweet stuff. The category of desserts is last, and the beverage group is for recipes not included, alcohol. The competition will be held on December 13th, but recipes are due on the 6th. For any more questions, contact Mahala Patrick on First Class.
So today's weather was quite different from yesterday's with the
snow. Yeah, it was really warm today.
Yeah, is that going to stick around?
Well, we'll see.
This is the current weather map of the country. Currently, we are seeing lots of clouds, but no precipitation as of yet. Slightly west of us, a cold front bringing snow. It should hit the Bangor area by tomorrow morning. The current surface map shows the cold front that will be approaching some parts of this storm seem to be carrying ice and slushy rain, indicated by the pink areas on the map. Current temperatures are hitting an unusually warm 47 in the Bangor area, up nearly 30 degrees from yesterday. Other parts of New England are also staying warm, most parts of Vermont and New Hampshire remaining in the 40s and 50s. Boston at a pleasant 53. Looking at the precipitation forecast, it looks like we may get hit with minor rain this evening, which will steadily change into snow by tomorrow morning. Friday's forecast shows heavy snowfall for the whole northeast area, spreading all the way through Pennsylvania, even to Michigan. The rest of the country looks clear and dry. The five-day forecast promises a cloudy week, with temperatures dropping steadily. But should stay mild throughout the next few days. Rain mixed with snow showers are expected to occur tonight through Saturday, but clear up for the rest of your weekend.
Well, that sounds not too bad for the weekend.
Not too bad, no. Right. Not nearly as cold as yesterday.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Heather. 'Tis the season to give, and the residents on campus are on board, is looking to help give to those in need. ROC is holding a toy and gift drive and has turned it into a competition between dorms. ROC will give the dorm who gives the most gifts a prize at the end of the season. ROC requests that gifts for teenagers and canned food be given, as the gifts will be wrapped and donated to the Maine Department of Children and Family Services, and the food will be given into food pantries. Any gift given to any hall governing board can be taken care of by the RD of the in particular dorm. A scare for the fast food chain restaurant Taco Bell happened this week in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and parts of New York. 5,800 U.S. Taco Bell restaurants suggested they may be responsible for the E. coli outbreak that has sickened at least 36 people in these three states. Testing has been done on scallions and was removed from the restaurants Wednesday because it appeared some had a dangerous strain of bacteria. Taco Bell would not release the information to the supplier of the scallions. However, California is the nation's largest supplier of green onions. But by December, as winter sets in, the vegetable is often imported from Mexico. 9 people remained hospitalized, including an 11-year-old boy in stable condition with kidney damage. New Jersey's health commissioner has stated that the last E. coli breakout was November 29th and that the danger of infection should be passed over by now.
On Tuesday, the popular hangout site, MySpace.com, announced it will develop technologies to help lock convicted sex offenders. MySpace is partnering with Sentinel Tech Holding Corporation to build and deploy this technology within 30 days. The program is a database that will contain the names and physical descriptions of the offenders in the United States. The system will search for matches between the database and registered user profiles. Employees will then delete the profiles that match. This is the site's last attempt to address complaints about sexual predators and other dangers to teens. Of the 24 million children using MySpace, it is reported that 1 in 5 have been sexually assaulted.
Finally, today marks the 65th anniversary of the attacks on Pearl Harbor. We wish to keep those in mind who lost their life in service to our country.
And that's all for the news today.
Tune in next Thursday when we'll have the latest news on campus. Thank you and have a good day. I'm sorry.